Aim. Fire.
Hi guys, Nepizon is here. Welcome to another episode how to make the ace in World of Tanks. If you are not interested in making the ace, surely this will help you to perform better in the game. This time I picked the tier 6 French light tank, the AMX-12T. This tank is the first automatic loader French light tank. Although the top speed is high, the AMX-12T has poor acceleration, so you can use it only in passive scouting. So let's go to the tactic to see the position of the AMX-12T. To get the AMX-12T, you will start with the AMX-38 at tier 3 with an incredible armor for its tier, followed by the AMX-40 at tier 4, also with an incredible armor for its tier. At tier 5 we have the AMX-ERC, one of the best light tanks from the game. And at tier 6 we have the AMX-12T. So let's see how we gonna upgrade this tank. We gonna put the second pair of tracks that has 38 travel speed, the last engine with 250 horsepower, the last radio with 750 meter signal range, the turret is the stock turret with 380 meter view range, 44 travel speed and 30 millimeter frontal armor. And from these two guns we gonna put this one. The 75 millimeter SA-50 gun. This gun is an autoloader with 6 shells in the magazine, 2.22 seconds of one shell loading and 20 seconds the time of the complete loading. And look here guys, this gun has 144 millimeter of penetration with AP and it costs 109 credits per shell, 202 millimeter of penetration with the gold round and that is APCR and it costs 2800 credits per shell, and 38 millimeter of penetration with the HE and it costs 98 credits per shell. The damage with the HE is 175 and with the AP and APCR is 135. The accuracy is good, 0.36. The aiming time is bad for a light tank, it's only 2.5 seconds. The gun depression is very bad, is only minus 4 degrees. After upgrading the tank, let's see now the general stats. As you can see, a very standard hit points for a tier 6 light tank, 600. It weighs almost 12.5 tons fully equipped. It has an engine with 250 horsepower, that means around 20 horsepower per ton. The top speed is very good, is 60 km per hour. The travel speed is bad for a light tank, it's only 38 degrees per second. But let's see now the armor. The hull is 50 mm on the front, 20 mm at the sides and 15 mm at the rear. The turret is garbage. Is 30 mm on the front, 20 mm at the sides and 20 mm at the rear. As you can see, the armor is paper thin on this tank. My XFMA mod is calculating 18.75 seconds the gun actual reload time. The turret traverse is very good, is 44 degrees per second. The view range is very good, 380 meters, but with the crew skills and equipment increases to 485 meters. The signal range from 750 meters increases to almost 800 meters. I'm not gonna check the AMX-12T's armor in the tank inspector because his armor is not effective. So, the first step after upgrading the tank is the crew skills. The AMX-12T has a crew of only 3 members. The commander, the gunner and the driver. The commander is also the radio operator and the loader. The gunner is also the loader. So, the two most important skills in the game are, like I always said, Sixth Sense and Brothers in Arms. But the most important skill for a light tank is camo. The second step is the equipment. We're gonna put the improved ventilation class 1 that gives plus 5% to all crew skills. The camonet active when the vehicle is stationary. And the binocular telescope that gives you plus 25% view range active when the vehicle is stationary. The third is the exterior. Although the AMX-12T's camo values are great, let's make it better. We're gonna apply camo for 7 days. Winter, summer, and desert. This paint gives the tank plus 3% better camo values. The fourth step is the consumables, which are small repair kit, small first aid kit, and the automatic fire extinguisher that gives plus 10% to fire protection. So, with these combinations that you see here, you have to make the ace. Let's see now this tank in action. Go. We are in the replay now. The map is Karelia and we are the attacking team. As you can see on bottom tier, this is a common situation when you are in a light tank. So let's see how we can fight with our tier 6 against the tier 9 heavies. By the way, this map is excellent for spotting. Because this tank has an autoloader, the important thing is not the DPM, but the one clip damage. The AMX-12T has 6 shells with 135 damage, that means 810 damage for one clip. So I see the first enemy, the T8 French light tank. I put a shot in his side. The other AMX-12T appears, so... One. And he is killed thanks to my spot. Now we are reloading again. And I'm going for the other AMX. Come on. One. Two. And we have our first kill. But unfortunately, we had to use our repair kit. Let's move to avoid Arty. Finally, we are in position now. Let's reload again before we go to attack. I see the back of the AMX and one. He pulls back. Let's advance. I have some teammates camping on the hill. So, let's spot for them. I hate heavies camping on the back, but Let's make them useful. I was spotting got the IS-3 killed, and now we finish the crippled AMX 5100. This is our second kill. Oh boy, a more dangerous autoloader is coming, the tier 9 American medium tank. 1 2 3 4. Oh no, it wasn't enough. But he was also killed thanks to our spotting. I reload again before the IS-3 arrives here. Come on. A miss. One. And he is killed, but the Carnarvon crippled me badly. We are reloading again. Come on.
Target acquired.
One.
Armor is damaged.
Two. Oh no, he killed me. This was pretty much it for me. Let's see now the postgame stats. So here is our mastery badge, Ace Tanker. We got 1828 experience with the premium account. We managed to give 1818 damage. We picked up only 2 kills, but we received 1219 basic experience. Shots fired 19, direct hits 13, 13 penetrated, and look here guys, 1727 spot damage. We made 45,592 credits, which gave us 38,871 credits profit with the premium account. Personally, I don't like playing with this tank because it doesn't have the mobility of a light tank. What about you guys? Do you like playing with the AMX-12T or not? Please share your thoughts in a comment below. Thank you guys for watching, I hope you enjoyed this, good luck on the battlefield and see you in the next episode.